I should explain that our backyard is not typically this crowded. But the size and the spirit of today's gathering is just a small reflection of the deep devotion of some 70 million American Catholics. You remind us that the Lord's most powerful message is mercy. And that means welcoming the stranger with empathy and a truly open heart. From the refugee who flees war-torn lands to the immigrant who leaves home in search of a better life. Holy Father, we are grateful for your invaluable support of our new beginning with the Cuban people, which holds out the promise of better relations between our countries, greater cooperation across our hemisphere, and a better life for the Cuban people.
As the son of an immigrant family, I'm happy to be a guest in this country, which was largely built by such families. American Catholics are committed to building a society which is truly tolerant and inclusive, to safeguarding the rights of individuals and communities, and to rejecting every form of injustice, discrimination. With countless other people of goodwill, they are likewise concerned that efforts to build a just and wisely ordered society respect their deepest concerns and the right to religious liberty. I find it encouraging that you are proposing an initiative for reducing air pollution. Accepting the urgency, it seems clear to me also that climate change is a problem we can no longer be left to a future generation. When it comes to the care of our common home, we are living at a critical moment of history. We still have time to make the change needed to bring about a sustainable and integral development, for we know that things can change. Mr. President, the efforts which were recently made to mend broken relationships and to open new doors to cooperation within our human family represent positive steps along the path of reconciliation, justice, and freedom.